Hey fast drivers, I'm Rasta and I'm a moderator for TrackMania games on speedrun.com. Today, I'll show you how to speedrun TrackMania 2020. First, you will need a speedrun timer called Livesplit. Download it on their website. Extract the zip folder. Click on the created folder and launch Livesplit with a livesplit.exe file. A white timer with a black background should appear on your screen. Do a right click on the timer, go over Compare Against and select Personal Best and Game Time. You can now set your hotkeys to act remotely on Livesplit. Do a right click and click on Settings. I recommend my hotkeys for Trackmania speedruns if you have a numpad. Numpad 4 starts a speedrun or makes a split, which means that it switches to the next segment of a speedrun. Numpad 6 resets the timer. Numpad 8 goes back to a previous segment by removing the previous split. Numpad 9 skips to the next segment without doing a split. Numpad 5, numpad divide, and numpad multiply won't be used, so I won't cover those. On TrackMania 2020, we use the script to automate all these actions, so you will only have to use the hotkeys if the script messes up. In that case, please report the issue on the TrackMania Speedrunning Discord server. Now, make sure that global hotkeys are not active. The hotkeys can be used when the Livesplit window is active. To use the hotkeys only while you are playing, you will need a Livesplit component called Focused Hotkeys. Download the Focused Hotkeys component from this drive folder. Then, copy this DLL file in the Components folder inside the Livesplit folder. After that, close Livesplit and open it one more time. In the drive folder, you also find layout files and split files for full customization of Livesplit. In this tutorial, we'll use files made by myself, but you can create your own files. Go to layout files and download the free in-game time automatic files. Then go to split files and download the TrackMania 2020 folder. Now do a right click on the timer, go over Open Splits, click on From File, and select one of the two splits files for a category that you will be speedrunning. We'll see the difference between the two files later. Then do another right click on the timer, go over Open Layout, click on From File, and select one of the three layout files. The mini layout gives minimal information about your speedrun. The horizontal layout is an horizontal layout. And the full layout gives plenty of information about your speedrun. It's time to jump in the Autosplitter settings. An Autosplitter is a script that automatically takes charge of starting a speedrun and making splits. The script for TrackMania 2020 also has a built-in in-game timer that only runs when you're driving on a track. Do a right-click on Livesplit, click on Edit Splits, then click on Activate, and finally on Settings. On the top, you want the Start, Split and Reset boxes to be selected. Then, you have several options. The first option automatically splits every time you cross the finish line on a track. This option is highly recommended. The second option automatically splits every time you cross a checkpoint on a track. Select this option if your split file includes splits for checkpoints. The third option automatically starts the timer on any track. Select this option for Track of the Day speedruns or for custom speedruns. The fourth option will create a log file with your detailed game time after each successful speedrun. Always select this option. The fifth and the sixth option allow you to select on which training or seasonal tracks you want to split on the finish line. If one of these options is selected, you'll have to uncheck the first and the second options. After you've chosen the correct script settings, you should be ready to go. Launch the first track of a speedrun. The timer should start at the end of a 3-2-1 countdown. The timer will switch to the next segment when you cross the finish line on any track. If you selected checkpoint splits, the timer will speed to the next segment once you cross a new checkpoint. To reset your speedrun, go back to the menu and select the first map. If the timer doesn't reset, wait for a 3-2-1 countdown to end and restart the track or use the reset hotkey. When your speedrun is finished, press the reset hotkey and save your splits files. A log file should have been created in the Livesplit folder inside the TrackManiaTimes folder. Open your log file and copy the text. To submit your speedrun, go to speedrun.com/tm and then look for your category. Then, click on Submit Run. In the description box, paste the text from the log file, then look for your final time at the bottom and copy it in the in-game time boxes. To find your real time, check your video recording or open Livesplit, click on Edit Splits, then on Real Time, scroll down and copy your time with an accuracy of 1 second. Then enter the date of the speedrun and the video link to your run. It should be a YouTube or Twitch link, as these two websites are embedded by speedrun.com. Sharing your splits files is recommended to help everyone compare against each other. Go to splits.io and sign in with your Twitch account. Then click on Upload and select your splits files. Click on Edit and then Set to Game Time. Look at the URL, copy the alphanumeric code and paste it in your speedrun submission. You can also add some comments to your speedrun and then click on Submit. Your speedrun will finally be reviewed by the speedrun moderators before it is published to the leaderboards. When other runners share the splits file on splits.io after the speedrun, you can easily compare against them. Make sure you use the same splits files as the other runner, because we made two splits files for each category, the checkpoint splits files giving the most precise view of your progress. In Livesplit, click on Edit Splits and then on Import Comparison. The From File option is used when someone directly shares the splits files to you. The From URL option used when you copy the URL of the splits file you'll find on splits.io/game/tm. The From Speedrun.com option lets you compare against any runner who shared their speed.io URL their speedrun submission. Thank you for watching this tutorial. If you have any questions, share them in the comments. If you enjoyed the video and you want to support my channel, like this video, subscribe, or share it to others. Bye bye!